Well, last night it was an occasion where the Dungeon of Doom took advantage of an outnumbered group of four horsemen. But tonight at Nitro, the horsemen turned the tables on Eddie Guerrero.
Benoit in an extraordinary amount of pain. And regardless of how you feel about that victory, you've got to tip your hat to both Guerrero and Benoit. McMichael, on the other hand, outsmarted Guerrero. He's just scum. Guerrero down. Benoit on him for the count. Referee Nick Patrick, distracted by a woman, gets down, notices a pin. One, two, and a three. And your winner, the wounded Chris Benoit over the wounded Eddie Guerrero.
And the wounded Nick Patrick is standing by for an interview. Let's hear it. Come on, Tony.
All right, Eric, thanks a lot. Nick Patrick is slowly making his way to us. And as you can see, we are joined by his attorney, Alan Sharp. And you know,
hold
a lot of
there. Hold it there, Brill Cream boy, okay? If you have any questions for my client, you direct those through me before you, Mr. Schiavone, distort the truth. Let me tell you how it really is, okay? It's my turn to talk, okay? Too hard for you? Mr. Patrick, Mr. Nick Patrick, has been an honest, hard-working official and referee at World Championship Wrestling. This man has given his all to the professionalism of this great sport.
Right.
The other night, he was unfairly questioned in a highly controversial match between the Macho Man Randy Savage and Hollywood Hulk Hogan. All this controversy, it didn't have to happen. It really didn't, because of one person. One person, and we know who that is. It was Chris Jericho.
Oh, give me a break.
Earlier in the evening, Mr. Jericho, in a match, brutally and viciously attacked my client, further aggravating an injury that Macho Man Randy Savage had occurred and injured my client weeks earlier.
Uh-oh.
Chris Jericho is out here. Chris, you've heard what he just said.
Listen up. Everybody here knows it. Everybody watching at home knows it. Nick Patrick, there is absolutely nothing wrong with your neck.
Wait a minute.
On top of that, everyone also knows that you are a 100% paid employee of the New World Order.
Mr. Jericho, do you have problems with anger? Have you ever...
Listen, you little fly-by-night, you stay out of this. This has nothing to do with you.
Patrick,
don't touch
him, he'll sue you.
Patrick, you cost me the victory against Six in Las Vegas, and I will forget it. I will not forget it.
Take your hands off me. Did you ever have problems with playing with other children when you were young? Possible some professional counseling would be in order, Mr. Jericho.
Wait a minute, Teddy
Come on,
Long is right. Teddy,
what's
going on here?
I've got one thing to say, okay? Let me say one thing right now to you, Mr. Patrick's attorney. Now, where I'm from, they call people like you scam artists, okay? Now, if you didn't have a degree, you'd probably be standing on the corner with a squeegee in your hand, begging for quarters to wash windows. Now, let me let you know another thing, okay? Nick Patrick is sandbagging, and you know it as well as I know it. Here's a young and upcoming star in WCW that Nick Patrick is trying to hold back.
You know, I can't even believe, Mr. Long, that you even had the gall or even the guts to question me in front of millions of people all over the world. You know what that's called? Let me put it in language that even you can understand.
What is it called?
It's called slander.
Oh, kill me.
Slander. Do you understand what slander means?
Out of this. I smell lawsuits.
Yeah, I understand what slander means.
And people wonder why
you're
turning.
Slander.
Mr. Long,
are so despised.
You know what's going to happen?
There's not enough
perfect
of
example. Not enough of them.
Oh, no. It's an honorable profession.
So
I have three uncles
you're
attorneys.
You're going to get pulp friction. Do you understand?
We're going to have to get out of this, all right?
This
ladies and gentlemen, we're going to have more
I
on
thought
Nitro
we were going to get
this time
installed.
Out. Sorry. Obviously, he's got an attorney in here pleading his case.
Kind of a sidebar.
Stuck with this maggot.
WCW, where the big boys play. The superstars of WCW are coming to a city near you.
Friday night at the Hammond, Indiana Civic Center. Saturday night at Kellogg Arena in Battle Creek, Michigan. This Sunday night at the Saginaw, Michigan Civic Center. And next Monday night at Van Andel Arena in Grand Rapids, Michigan for Monday Nitro. This is where the big boys play. This is WCW.
All right, welcome back. We are live. And in case you just joined us, later on, you will hear that interview, Roddy Piper confronting Hollywood Hulk Hogan. Hogan has demanded tonight an opportunity to respond. He had an opportunity last night. I don't know why he didn't say whatever he wanted to say to Piper's face, but he'll say it tonight, and we will endure it. He will get his 5 minutes of interview time or whatever it's going to turn out to be. Booker T here to take on Lex Luger, and Luger is on a roll. He looked great last night in his match with L.A. Arn Anderson.
We're still here, live and in living color. Let somebody go get hurt.
Well, conspicuous by his absence, obviously, is Colonel Parker, and I know that there may be some dissension within the ranks because the Harlem Heat, I believe, blame Colonel Parker for losing those tag team titles to the Outsiders.
And here he comes. Lex Luger, this man, as I said, is on a roll. He told us what he was going to do before Halloween Havoc. He got into the ring, the bell rang, and he did it. He executed, and he executed flawlessly. Not taking away anything from Arn Anderson, because he is one of the top competitors in this sport, but Luger is on the roll, and we've been waiting for it. It's finally beginning to click the way it should have. Maybe Luger's gotten rid of this whole Sting situation. Maybe he's left it behind, or maybe he's passed it up. I don't know. But whatever the case may be, Luger's back in top form.
Well, Arn Anderson said he was a quitter, and Arn Anderson is no quitter. He's a man all the way. But last night at Stingin' Hollywood Halloween Havoc, when Luger had him across his shoulders in that rack, one thing Luger did not do, he didn't quit. He didn't let go of that hold. He had it on Arn Anderson for quite an amount of time. As far as we know, he's still in the hospital.
This is another case where both of these wrestlers were involved in very physical matchups last night. You're right, Luger not only promised to rack Anderson, which he did, he promised to injure him, and he followed through on that promise, hospitalizing the enforcer.
And maybe Luger's going to be that leader that WCW needs if Sting is going wherever Sting is going.
Well, Luger looked like he was politicking for the job last night.
Let's go now to Colonel Parker. You're right about the dissension. Let's hear what Parker has to say.
I know there's a lot of you born yesterdays out there figuring that maybe there's some problem between myself, Booker T, and the Harlem Heat. Well, that's absolutely absurd. Maybe you're thinking that they're thinking out there that I was the reason they lost their belts at the Halloween Havoc. That's all so impossible. I know this, if they did think that, my beautiful twinkle eyes would take care of all of it in a snap.
Well, pretty much sums it up, Mike.
I still don't think that Colonel Parker, the Harlem Heat, and Sherry are on the same page, regardless of what he says.
Well, you mean to say that you think the Colonel and Sherry have drifted apart? You think there's trouble there? I mean, Twinkle Eyes, she's in love with the man. You can tell the way she looks at him.
Yeah, but what about the kiss last night at Halloween Havoc?
All right, Lex Luger on a roll, as we talked about earlier. Booker T, not quite on the same roll. Close match last night with Hall and Nash. And if you ask me, I'd like to see a rematch signed between these two, because in my opinion, Booker T and Stevie Ray are two guys that can break the momentum. Hall and Nash, they really didn't win those titles. They walked out with them, but they didn't win them.
And it's six-time World Tag Team Champions. They obviously deserve a rematch.
Hall and Nash, they want an office down the hall from Pets because they know somebody at Time Warner. Give me a break.
You know, eventually it'll happen. They'll move all Pets stuff out in the office, out in the hallway. You'll be living in an elevator, and they'll have all the suites. They'll do it, too.
Luger, absolutely dominant right now. Absolutely dominant. Whatever has happened to Luger over the past week has made all the difference in the world.
You know, usually you see Booker T in charge of a match. Usually you see him go out there and dominate a match. He's had no offense so far.
You'd have to say going in that Luger would have the advantage here because of the fact that it is a singles match.
Absolutely.
Booker T so reliant